YouTube, welcome to Thought Provoking Tuesday on Enoma, and we are going to give our reaction to How to Save a Life by the Fray. This is our first time single take honest reaction.
For sure, I've never heard about the Fray before, neither about the song. And it's a tribe request, so I'm really eager to listen to it because we get great requests from our tribe.
Step one, you say we need to talk. He walks, you say sit down, it's just a talk. He smiles politely back at you. You stare politely right on through. Some sort of window to your right. As he goes left and you stay right. Between the lines, fear and blame.
Almost 100% sure I've heard this guy's voice in a movie.
Okay.
So either this tune this song or some other song of the Fray, but I'm certain that I've heard this guy's voice. His voice is unique, so it's very easy for me to remember it. Wow, wow.
This is one of those songs where the content of the song matches so well with the way he sung it. I love the way he sung this song. There could not have been any better way to sing this.
Ooh, this is something that I've dealt with so much as a counselor. I mean, especially a relationship counselor, marital counselor, couples therapist. This is a topic I've dealt with many, many, many times. Quality time, quality conversation with your loved one is so important in today's world. It's very, very, very important. I mean, it's seriously lacking. That's what I know from my experience of last 20 years as a counselor and psychologist. Seriously lacking among most people, whether I've read about it, seen it, or counsel clients. Quality time. I mean, it started off so beautifully. I guess it's about a parent and a child, and the child seems to be like a teenager or a school kid. And they wanted to have a talk, and they decided to have a talk, and then one went left and the other stayed right, and that was that. I guess after that, he wished he had stayed up all night.
So that
he could talk, and yeah, if he knew how to save a life, that would save a life. And that's how simple it is. I mean, it's amazing for many people to hear when I say this. It is that simple to save a life. It's not about the first aid, or it's not about the when a person does something, you know, silly to end their life. It's about before that, a lot before that. You can save a life, you and me can save a life by spending quality time talking to each other. Talking to each other without the TV on. Talking to each other about each other. Talking to each other about stuff going on in each other's lives. Listening to each other. Because if one talks, the other must be mature enough to listen. And if one listens, then the other must be mature enough to talk. Both can't listen at the same time, and both can't talk at the same time. But most important is the time. We must spend that quality time with our loved ones, and that is all that Fray is trying to say, in my humble opinion, as a counselor who's counseled over 1,000 clients for issues pertaining to this. This is a common issue. People do not spend quality time with each other. People do not have face-to-face conversations with each other in today's world. And even if they do, it is about other things. It's about movies, it's about politics, it's about the headlines in the news, it's about terror attacks, it's about everything else apart from me and you. What are your thoughts, Kirti?
For me, this was about that moment, that exact juncture. What decides whether somebody lives or dies the next moment, the same night, the same day. So many times we underestimate or ignore certain signs and symptoms that are very evidently there in front of our eyes. Sometimes we think there has been so many times it has happened that nothing is going to go wrong or nothing is going to happen the next time or this time. But what happens is sometimes you have to know, or your instincts have to tell you, this time is the different time than all the other past ones that we've had. Sometimes we argue with our loved ones. Sometimes it's just a small argument and it remains. Or sometimes even a big argument happens and it just, you know, we move on after that the next day. But there are certain things, certain hints you must pay attention to, and you must act upon it instantly, the same night, same day when it happens. Because you could save that person's life. There are, you know, so many instances, so many cases where a person just made a phone call to his loved one. Just to tell that, you know, maybe to say that this is I'm at the brim of things. And if things don't work out now, I won't be there. But the opposite person doesn't realize that at that moment, because they feel that he said it 1001 times. And what is this? This is not going to be something new. And that may have been the last call of the person. He's just giving it the last shot for that. If you understood that call, you would have saved that person's life. If in this song, if the person understood the argument that they were having, and you know, when we argue about things, we have fears and we blame for things to each other, just like the song says. There is a very fine line between the fears and the blame that we play on with each other. And it's okay sometimes to lose an argument, as per the song. Because that argument, not winning, would, you know, help somebody else live another day or live a longer life. I remember the movie, The Dangerous Minds. In that, this is the most crucial time in the movie. When the student of hers who was going to have this fight the next day, and she knows the intensity of it, that if she doesn't stop that from happening the next day, he might die or the opposite guy might die, and this will be the deciding, you know, thing for the student. She takes that student, even though he is highly dangerous, you know, in the movie, and she takes him home. She keeps him home for the entire night so that he remains with her and he doesn't do anything unpredictable the next day. But what kills him is when he goes to the principal and talks to him about, you know, wanted to talk to him about his behavior and things like that. And he wanted to make a change because he was inspired by his teacher. And the principal just tells him, you know, he doesn't knock the door. He just walks in because he didn't have the manners. The principal just tells him, don't you have the manners to knock the door? And this guy loses it and he goes out and he dies the same day. And that hits
me. Yeah, I would like to just... you know, add another element to this. If we look even beyond the lyrics, which is really, really important as reactors, that is what we always strive to do in such cases, with such songs, we must also add another element. We live in a world where there are, you know, a million plus accidents happening every single year. I don't even know the right statistic. I don't even know if I can have the right statistic. But I'm sure that there are a million plus accidents that occur in a year around the world. And many of those accidents are fatal accidents. Many are where limbs are lost. Many are burns and things like that. You know, we don't really know. We don't really know when it will be or might be the last time we see a loved one's face or we get to spend some quality time with our loved ones. We don't really know. We live in a crazy, chaotic, troubled world. And we don't really know. We can't really tell if we are going to be alive tomorrow. Whether you or me or her. We can't really tell. We live in that kind of a world today. And it is not exaggerating things. So it's really, really important. Forget about instances like this, where you know that this could be the end. There are ordinary days. Why leave it till that extent when we wait till that time? Why not do it every single day anyway? Because every single day could be your last day on the planet or your loved one's last day on the planet. Every single day that we create a reaction could be our final day on YouTube. You know, and that is what I always treasure. Whenever I make a reaction, there's no hurry to complete it. There's no hurry to just, you know, she said her bit, I've said my bit, let's wind it. There's no hurry. You know, it's not about the views, it's not about the subscribers, it's not about the money we make or don't make. It's about how we really analyze, react to this music. This is a brilliant song. I may not have heard of the Fray before. I don't know if it's a musician's name or a band. I don't know. But this song is a brilliant song. This song is intense. It's remarkable. It's astonishingly amazing. We need to spend time talking to the ones that really matter. If we don't do that, do they really matter? That is the question we need to ask ourselves. Do those ones matter if we do not want to spend time with them. I'd like to conclude my take with saying something. I would always ask my students in my classrooms, very often I would ask them, especially if they were working people, I would ask them, why do you work? This was for my own research at most times. I wanted to know why people worked, and I also wanted to tell them what I gathered from the inputs of asking this question for 20-25 years of my life. Why do you work? You can ask yourself that question right now if you're a working person or will be working soon. I will ask myself the same question even though I've already done that 1,000 times. Why do we react? Why do you work? People say we work so that we can have a better life. We work to pay the bills. We work to put good food on the table for our kids. We work to send our kids to good institutions to study. We work for a brighter future for our family and our next generation. We work for this, 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 this. And as they talk more and more and more, different voices, different people in the classrooms, everyone is basically saying the same thing. We work because it gives us money for the end. What is the end purpose? The end purpose is to have more love in our lives, is to have better relationships with our loved ones. Bottom line, we work for the ones we love the most and matter the most to us. But if that's the case, my question to them is always, what comes? And I don't mind if people hate me for that in the classroom. Nobody does, because they realize I'm exactly what I'm saying. If you work for your loved ones, money is just getting you there. If you work for your loved ones, why on earth don't you spend quality time with them, talking to them, instead of doing so many other things which are just irrelevant in the larger scheme of things? That's what I want to say.
Most people, when it comes to shopping, they remember one thing. That you have to live life as if this is the last day on earth for you. When it comes to shopping, people find these reasons. But when it comes to relationships, when it comes to love, they don't give the same line. That you have to live and you have to show your love to your loved ones as if this is the last day that you're living on earth, and tomorrow you might not see your loved one again. This is a common excuse it has become in the shopping driven world, that you have to do everything now, because if I don't take it now, this will be the end. Every sale I have to grab, but the sale will keep coming. The loved ones don't keep coming. Once they go, they are gone.
Yeah. You only live once.
But not just for shopping, for all. Thanks for watching.